Well, many of you submitted questions in our chat room. And Pat, this first one is from Thana, who says, a few years ago, I cheated on my husband. I felt really bad about it. I have repented and haven't cheated on him since. My question is, should I tell my husband or just leave it in the past?
You know, that's a very difficult question. It's a very difficult question because in certain instances, you're better. Certainly things that happened before you came to the Lord or before you got married, that's between you and the Lord. Keep it quiet. You just don't need to drag up old boyfriends, old girlfriends, all the stuff, sexual escapades. Mm-hmm. No way. That's yours, between you and Jesus. In this case, it's a question of what your own heart tells you. Does your heart tell you that you've got to tell him? Well, if that's the case, you pray that the Lord will make him receptive and not angry. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, if your heart is not telling you to do it and you don't feel leading the Lord, then don't do it. There's no compulsion that you have to. You've confessed to the Lord, and that's the important thing. Now, if you have, you say, well, I've injured him and I should go and apologize. Well, did you or did you? I mean, it's a difficult, difficult question. Mm-hmm. And
It is. It's an odd thing because, really, there's so much you don't know in answering that. What is the relationship like? But she doesn't say that between her and her husband. But sometimes that can cause an odd thing in the relationship.
Well, from now on, she's going to be saying, well, you reckon she's doing it again. And how was it, with that other guy? And was he something that she really liked? And then the husband starts fantasizing all this nonsense. I mean, it's better to be quiet, but you do what the Lord shows you. All right.
This is Lisa, who says, my spouse is a great husband and father, but at the same time, he likes to drink with his friends. He's come home drunk a few times, and it's starting to cause problems with our family. What should I do?
Mildly suggest to him that behavior isn't acceptable. But if he's not a drunk and he goes out and he tells a few of his friends, don't nag him. It would be very unwise to do so. You pray that the Lord himself will show him whether this is right or wrong. If he's beginning to abuse your children or something like that, that's a different matter. If he's beginning to beat you up, it's a different matter.
Yeah, she doesn't say why it's caused, what the
problems
in the family are.
That's right. That's the problem with these questions. You get just a little glimpse at what it is, and so it's not the full story. But nagging husbands is not cool. It doesn't accomplish what you're thinking.
Of course, neither is drinking too much and coming home drunk.
I know.
It's a
He's a convivial son of Ireland, and they like that. I mean, that's part of the culture. I don't know.
I think what you said is correct, that, sit down in a time when he's not drinking and when you're having maybe you can say, can we go out to dinner somewhere? There's something I want to talk with you about, and just share your heart about that in a moment where he's in a good place to listen to you.
So, it's always, I love you so much, and look what's going to happen. Okay, what's next?
This is Gwendolyn, who says, I was recently introduced to something called the energy bracelet. Supposedly it involves magnets and helps blood flow or something, but a friend of mine says it's new age and demonic. What do you think?
I don't think magnets are demonic.
I also
think it's a scam, but that's neither here nor there.
It's your money.
But they have these bracelets, you have stuff. I mean, maybe it does some good for you. I don't know. But
There was a while not too long ago where people who had back injuries, they had magnets that you could actually put in your bed when you sleep at night.
Magnetism might help, but it's electrical. It's not a demon. It's electrical impulses. So,
So if that energy works, let us know.
If you want to grab a hot wire and hold on, see if that's
that's very that fixes energizing,
you.
Too.
Yeah, that'll energize you. All right, what else?
Okay, this says, I'm 19 years old and completely lost in life. Everyone around me tells me that I should have some sort of notion of a career path by now. I've prayed for direction, but those prayers have gone unanswered. What should I do? This is from Nicole.
Nicole, praise God for where you are. And do what's right before you, one step at a time. You at 19 are not going to know your life's goals. You really won't. I didn't know when I was 19 what I was going to do.
I know 40-year-olds who haven't figured out their life path.
Well, you just don't necessarily know. I thought I'm going to be a lawyer. But why? Well, I just was going to do that. But, I mean, the thought that I'd be doing what I'm doing now would have totally in another world, not a chance.
You know what sometimes happens to 19-year-olds? You're getting ready to go to college or onto training, and your parents want to know that you're majoring in something you're going to use later in your life. I think it's an exploration time myself to figure out what your gifts are and what your heart's
in? I studied, I majored in history. History was fun. I got good grades. It was everything. Everybody bought and I had a lot of parties. I mean, when you're that age, you're not, you gotta, then I went to the Marine Corps, was overseas. I mean, the Marines, hey.
One day with Jesus. Just one day with Jesus.